Hello everyone, dear children. In this video I will discuss the chapter The Selfish Giant. It has been taken from your book It So Happened. I am sure you have also read the story, as I had assigned this task of reading the story to you during your holidays. It's a very beautiful story written by Oscar Wilde. Let's see what is there, what is the theme, and what is the lesson that we learn out of this story. Okay, dear students, I'm not going to tell you about Oscar Wilde in detail. It's a task for you. You have to find out the detailed biography of Oscar Wilde and write a short note on it in your notebooks, right? This chapter, The Selfish Giant, it is one of the most beautiful stories written by Oscar Wilde. It had been first published in 1888 with other stories, The Nightingale and the Rose, The Devoted Friend, The Remarkable Rocket, and The Happy Prince. It is a short story with the elements of fairy tales and fantasy in it. Let's talk about the summary of the chapter now. Look at the picture. You can see what giant man is there standing in the garden. This story is about a giant who is said to be very, very selfish. He had a beautiful garden where the children played when he was away during 7 years. He had not been in his garden for last 7 years, and by the time what happened, children of the surrounding area, they used to come to this garden to play. One summer afternoon, the giant returned to his garden and saw the children playing in, and he bellowed at them to get out. Bellowed means shouted. When he saw the children, he got very angry. By his selfishness, a very high wall was built around his garden so that the children could not go inside to play. So he had objection that children should not come to his garden, and he did not want anyone to come to his garden to play. So he shouted at the children and got a wall built around it. As spring turned into summer outside the wall, within the giant's garden, it remained winter. No flowers, no bird songs, and no children. All garden was covered by the snow and the frost. So what happened? The season changed, but the season inside the wall or in the garden of the giant did not change at all. Then one morning the giant awoke to a strange sound. The sound was of a bird song. A bird was singing so sweetly in his garden. He followed the sound to a far corner of the garden where he found some children playing happily. In this corner of the garden, just this corner, the birds were singing and the garden was beautiful again. So he went to work on the wall. Within hours, he had knocked it down. He got the idea that when children will come to his garden, birds also will follow them, and the seasons will also change inside the garden. So what did he do? He knocked down the wall. He broke it away. That evening, the garden was filled with the sound of happy children playing. The giant lay back, finally contented. Contented, happy, satisfied. It is your garden now, little children. So now he allowed all the children to come to his garden, and he was very happy to share his garden with all these children. Then the next day, the children found him dead, covered in blossoms on the ground. But very sadly, next morning, the children found that the giant had died and his body was all covered with flowers. The little boy whom the selfish giant had helped in climbing the tree previously had now taken him to paradise, and the giant finally figured out that he should not be selfish after all. Dear students, this little boy was nobody else but God himself, who had come down to earth to teach a lesson to this selfish giant. The selfish giant also took a lesson, and he could realize that the real worth of life lies only in helping others, loving others, and sharing our things with others. In this way, when he learned this lesson, he got paradise as a reward. Let's see what transformation the character of the selfish giant undergoes. He was a selfish giant. This statement has been made by the author, him, his personality. So it makes sure to the readers that the major character of the story is really very selfish. He's too selfish, she said. This sentence has been said by the autumn season. She wants to give the giant a lesson because of his selfishness. So all the sentences are indicating that he was very, very selfish. But we will see that there is a change in him after he meets the children, after meeting the children. And the giant's heart melted as he looked out. How selfish I have been, he said. The situation made him realize that he was a very selfish person. Then he says, now I will know why the spring would not come here. I will put that poor boy on the top of the tree and then I will knock down the wall and my garden shall be the children's playground forever and ever. So this is how his statements now have changed. He is now ready to allow the children inside the garden. He realized that he was a very selfish person. So he would put the poor boy on the tree's branch and also made his garden as the playground for the children forever. All this means that the selfish giant has now transformed himself. He had now changed himself. He was now a very good human being and his selfishness had altogether left him. So his heart had melted now and he loved the children very much now. The story seems to have a sad ending because the giant dies and the children who loved him find him lying dead and covered with flowers in the garden. The part where the giant dies also confirms that he goes to a better place after death. The little boy takes him to paradise. That is his reward for his selfless love. Oscar Wilde has showed us the way to happiness through true love and selflessness. At last, the giant became happy and his soul was taken to paradise. We could also find that love has all the power and after death, we can get to a better place if we have love in our hearts for others. Similarly, giant also had his reward at the end of the story as he was taken to paradise because he had developed love for the children. This is all about the story, The Selfish Giant. Dear children, do go through the story again and again if you have not read it during your holidays and try to solve all the exercises given in the textbook. If you need any help, you can call me anytime. Thank you.